Good morning from beautiful Glen Spey, New York. It is an absolutely gorgeous morning and excited to get it started. Sorry for the lack of vlog yesterday. There's some big internet issues here I need to figure out. Hopefully I'll be able to get this one up. But good morning. Hope you're doing well. Happy Friday to you. Getting ready to start session 2. Friday morning. We're really, really excited about it. The guys are just like fired up. They're excited to go. I'm ready to go. It's awesome. They always start each session with a lot of comedy stuff from these guys that are just hilarious. So I'm being really quiet because I'm backstage, but we're ready to rock and roll. Like I said, welcome to Lake Champion. This is a beautiful, beautiful place that's owned by Young Life. It's a gorgeous camp, and we get to do this every single year for the last 3 years. Basically, this is a men's retreat. It's a Christian men's retreat. It's run by a company called Priority One. Priority One is a company, an organization that basically their main mission is to introduce Christ into the lives of men. And so churches from all over, basically the Northeast, from North Carolina to Maine, essentially, they all gather this specific weekend, one weekend a year, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, to this place, Lake Champion, up in Glen Spey, New York, and we have a retreat for 4 days. During those 4 days, we have the privilege of leading worship for the men, which is just an awesome thing. We love doing it, and it's always one of the highlights of the year. And then there is a speaker that comes in from somewhere in the country. Each year, it's a different speaker. This year is a gentleman named Chris, a great guy. And it's just a time of refreshment. It's a time for Christian men, but also non-Christian men, friends of people that they invite, are just able to come and enjoy their time. Lots of free time involved as well, where men just get to talk more, get to learn more, and just grow together. But it's also just a time to really hopefully recharge and grow closer in our walks with Christ, which is obviously extremely important for men in a busy, busy world. So I'm not necessarily saying it's the best idea, but we're all returning to the hardwood right now. There's a good chance that something will either pop, snap, or break. And I'm not gonna specifically say who I think it could happen to, but. Oh, real time update. Didn't take very long. We got a sprained ankle. He's already done. Josh, sprained ankle about 2 minutes into playing. He didn't play, he was just shooting around. Not a good start. I mentioned we're out of shape, but we've had 3 injuries already. All of them season ending in a matter of just a quick little 3-on-3 game. I mean, it's just pretty pathetic, really. We're down to free throw competition.
Thomas, what were you doing?
I was checking out Josh's sweet injury.
Scott, look at the size of this.
Oh, feel good?
No, does not feel good. Dude.
I just feel like I'm in Groundhog Day though on this weekend, because I feel like I keep doing the same things over and over. Yeah. I come back in this room, set up, break down.
So we are already about halfway through the weekend. It just goes super fast, but it's just awesome to just be together with these guys. It's cool to just see a group of guys all get together. and just grow together. I think part of what happens a lot in society and what happens a lot in just in general in busyness of life is just the fact that so many men, especially Christian men, they get caught just living life alone. They may work with people, they may have a spouse and a family, but they keep all their difficulties and their struggles to themselves. So what we talk about a lot at our church is just the idea that we are better together. So if you've been following this channel for a while, you may notice that I don't force religion down people's throats. I don't shove it in your face nonstop. I don't judge you if you believe this or you believe that. I just like to be as kind of a person as possible and let people go on their own journey. But obviously my faith is extremely important to me. I grew up in the church and I've been a Christian for a very long time. And that is how I live my life. I live my life by what the Bible says I should do and how I should treat people. And I don't always do it correctly. I mess up a lot and I'm always trying to get better at everything that I do. I'm going to try to be a better person to everyone. And I don't know what your walk of faith is, whether you're a Christian, whether you're not a Christian, whether you're an atheist. I don't know what it is. And honestly, I don't judge you in any way. I just like to be able to share how important it is to me. It's the foundation of everything that I do. It's how I was raised. And it's a huge part of who I am today. And I wouldn't be where I was. None of us would be where we are without, obviously, the cross and the fact that we have a God who sent his son to die for us on the cross. And that is extremely, extremely important to me. And it always will be. And I will never be a person that makes this channel all about that, because of the fact that I don't think that you should be forced. I think that you should watch how somebody lives, and if you believe that they are someone you'd want to be like and you find out that they are a believer and that they are a Christian and that's the reason they live that way, that's the ultimate testimony of who somebody is. Because forcing religion down someone's throat or just becoming religious per se but not actually living it out is not the way to live anyway. So I try to do all I can of just being a person that shows my faith, not as much talks about it, specifically for the sake of I want you to hopefully see a difference in me, not just hear about one, because I think a lot of people talk about a difference, they don't always live it. But it has been an awesome day, awesome couple of days so far. Excited to keep it going. Headed to dinner now.
Jimmy, you feeling like $1 million bucks?
I am, because no, I slept all afternoon.
He slept and lounged on the beach. He's the only one feeling perfect.
Well, just a really fantastic, fantastic day. Great weather, great day. Just love it. And I'm really exhausted though, and sore. So, Tom, go to bed. So people always ask me, is the A6500 a good camera for vlogging? Well, this entire vlog was shot on an A6500. So, what do you think?